In a previous lecture, we talked about the storm tracks and how they develop, how fast they develop, and where they go. Those were the storm tracks. Now let's talk about points of cyclogenesis. Here we have the Pacific Ocean, we have the Rocky Mountains, we have the Great Plains, and then we have the Mississippi River here, and then we have the Eastern, or the Midwest, and then the Appalachian Mountains, and then we end up with the coastal plain, and then the Atlantic. So let me go ahead and label these, the Pacific and the Atlantic. Okay, and in between we've got the Rockies. These are the Rockies. And then Mississippi. And then the Appalachian Mountains. Okay, so what we're dealing with here is topography and points of cyclogenesis. Now, we've talked about the Alberta Clipper and the Colorado Low and the Inside Leader. What we have, if you kind of looked at that map that we had in the previous video lecture, all of those points began on the eastern side of the Rockies. So as the air descends the Rockies on the eastern side, it warms up and will force cyclogenesis to occur. These are the points of strong cyclogenesis, where the mid-latitude cyclone will form. Now, as it comes, we see in maps that the mid-latitude cyclone does move from the Pacific Ocean into the United States. As it does, it dissipates because it's changing. It is forced to weaken because of the change in topography. All right. So then, when that system hits the Rockies, it's already dissipated. Then, east of the Rockies, we have cyclogenesis occurs at particular points. Now, the averages are Alberta, Canada, Colorado, and the inside or the Colorado Low, and then the Four Corners region. So we have cyclogenesis that begins here. As it progresses to the east, across the Great Plains and into the Midwest, it continues to develop, intensify, if you will. Once it hits the Appalachian Mountains, there's a bit of a weakness to its development. So it will kind of weaken, dissipate a little bit, but then once it goes past the Appalachian Mountains, it redevelops. It intensifies again. And if you're in the New England area or the New York, Boston area, sometimes we refer to these redeveloping systems as nor'easters. You have very gusty wind storm systems. Another point of cyclogenesis would be not as intense as the Rocky Mountain cyclogenesis, but here, east of the Appalachian Mountain, this would be another point of cyclogenesis. But this is going to be weak. This is going to be strong. Strong cyclogenesis east of the Rockies, weak cyclogenesis east of the Appalachian Mountains. And in particular, we call this, not for this particular class, but we call this the Hatteras Low. It develops in the Hatteras region of the eastern coast of the United States. So, in essence, the development of the mid-latitude cyclone is based on the topography. So if we did not have these mountains here in the United States at all, then we could expect that cyclogenesis would not occur because we don't have the changes in elevation. The changes of elevation cause cyclogenesis to occur.